So I welcome all of you to class number 7. So from the class number 6, we have started our discussion on pedal equations or PR equations. So we have already discussed one problem and one was given as exercise. And now in this video, we are going to consider third problem. So here the given curve is r square equal to a square secant 2 theta. That is in terms of the variables, I mean parameters, r and theta. Now we need to write this in terms of p and r. What is p? P is the length of the perpendicular from the origin or from the pole, you can say. So we have the equation in the parameters r and theta. Now we have to write this in terms of r and p. So that is what we call as PR equation. This is polar equation, you can say. And this is PR equation, and alternative name for this is pedal equation. Okay, so let us consider the given curve first. Given r square equal to a square secant 2 theta. R square equal to a square secant 2 theta. See, to write the PR equation or pedal form of the given equation, what we need to do is, first step, we need to determine phi, angle between the radius vector and the tangent for the given curve. Second step, you have to consider the equation p equal to r sine phi. You have to consider this equation if you get explicitly the value of phi. If you don't get explicitly the value of phi, then you have to use 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus cot square phi. So this equation you have to use. When this you have to use? When you get the value of phi implicitly. When you get the value of phi explicitly, you have to use p equal to r sin phi. Then eliminate theta from the given equation, and this you get the pedal equation or polar equation, PR equation. So given r square equal to a square secant 2 theta, so first I need to find phi, and we have already discussed many problems on this. So just you have to take log on both sides. Take log on both sides. If you take log on both sides, this will be simplified to 2 log r equal to, you can write 2 log a, that is not necessary. You can just write log a square plus log secant 2 theta. Now, differentiating both sides with respect to theta. Differentiating both sides with respect to theta. Here r equal to f of theta. So I have to treat r as a function of theta, right? Now differentiating both sides with respect to theta, left hand side will be 2 times of derivative of r, that is 1 by r, into derivative of r with respect to theta, that is dr by d theta, equal to log a square. On differentiating, that will be 0, log secant 2 theta. In the denominator you will get secant 2 theta. So in the numerator, derivative of secant theta is secant theta into tan theta, so it will be secant 2 theta into tan 2 theta into derivative of 2 theta is 2. So this 2 get cancelled on both sides, so you will be remaining with the left hand side is, okay, there is one more term to cancel, that is secant 2 theta, secant 2 theta. So the left hand term you will be remaining with cot phi equal to tan 2 theta. And we know that tan 2 theta we can write as, see, we have tan theta equal to cot of phi by 2 minus theta, right? Similarly, if you have minus tan theta, then it will be cot of phi by 2 plus theta. So using that results, we can write this tan 2 theta as cot of phi by 2 minus 2 theta. Cot of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. So we have cot phi equal to cot of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. From this we will be getting phi equal to pi by 2 minus 2 theta. So I got phi equal to pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Okay. Now as I said, after getting phi, next we need to, here I got phi explicitly. So I can consider the equation p equal to r sin phi. p equal to r sin phi. Substitute for phi here. Substituting for phi, we'll be getting p equal to r sin of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. R sin of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. See, sin of pi by 2 minus 2 theta, that will be in first quadrant. So this will be p, pi by 2 radhrinda, that changes to cos of 2 theta. First quadrant, all are positive. So I got r cos 2 theta. So given, what is the given statement? If you look into the given statement, r square equal to a square secant 2 theta. Given r square equal to a square secant 2 theta. Now we have to eliminate theta between these two variables. This involves p and r. This involves r and theta. I want equation in p and r. Oh, okay. This involves p, r and theta. This involves r and theta. I want only equation in terms of p and r. So I have to eliminate theta. Okay. If you eliminate theta, you get the required PR equation. So to eliminate theta, from this equation we have, okay, you can call this as 1, 2 for your reference. So from equation 1, taking secant to theta to the left hand side, 1 by secant to theta, that is cos 2 theta equal to a square by r square. And from equation 2, we'll be getting cos 2 theta equal to p by r. So this two implies a square by r square equal to p by r. A square by r square equal to p by r. So r get cancelled. So you got a square equal to pr. So this is the required PR equation. A square equal to pr is the required PR equation. That is the required pedal form. So next, D. Problem D is r power n equal to a power n cosine theta. R power n equal to a power n cos n theta. Solution. So here given r power n equal to a power n cos n theta. Given r power n equal to a power n cos n theta. Okay. Now as usual, first we need to find phi, right? So taking log on both sides, we'll be getting n log r equal to log a power n plus log cos n theta. Okay. After applying the properties of logarithms, the given expression can be simplified to n log r equal to log a power n plus log cos n theta. Now, differentiating with respect to theta, this will be n into 1 by r into dr by d theta equal to log a power n, that will be 0, plus denominator you will be having cos n theta, and numerator will be derivative of cos is minus sin. So derivative of n theta will be n. So minus n sin n theta. Now n you can cancel on both sides. So n get cancelled. Left hand side you can write as cot phi. So cot phi equal to minus sin n theta by cos n theta, that is tan n theta. That is tan n theta. But as I said here, if you use the property of tan and cot, minus tan theta equal to cot of pi by 2 plus theta. So here you will be getting minus tan n theta equal to cot of pi by 2 plus n theta. Pi by 2 plus n theta. So I got phi equal to pi by 2 plus n theta. I got phi equal to pi by 2 plus n theta. Now consider. See, I got here phi explicitly. So I can consider p equal to r sin phi. Can consider p equal to r sin phi. Substituting for phi, we'll be getting p equal to r sin of pi by 2 plus n theta. So it will be p equal to r cos n theta. It will be in second quadrant. So sin will be positive. So you get p equal to r cos n theta. Okay, you can call this as equation 1. And given, write the given equation. What is given? R power n equal to a power n cos n theta. So from this, you can write cos n theta equal to r power n divided by a power n. From equation 1, we have, see, from equation 1, I can write cos n theta equal to p by r. So these two implies r power n divided by a power n equal to p by r. Or equivalently, a power n into p equal to r power n plus 1. That is the required PR equation. A power n into p equal to r power n plus 1. So that is about problem D. Next, problem E. The given equation is r power m equal to a power m cos m theta plus sin m theta. R power m equal to a power m into cos m theta plus sin m theta. So as usual, given r power m equal to a power m cos m theta plus sin m theta, cos m theta plus sin m theta. Now taking log on both sides and simplifying this expression, so I'll be getting taking log on both sides m log r equal to log a power m plus log of cos m theta plus sin m theta. I think we have already considered the similar problem two times, I think. So now differentiating both sides with respect to theta. So we'll be getting m by r into dr by d theta, m by r into dr by d theta. So log a power m is 0, denominator line baratha. Okay, write the numerator. Derivative of cos m theta minus m sin m theta plus derivative sin m theta m cos m theta divided by the denominator is cos m theta plus sin m theta. So I can cancel m on both sides. Okay, let us cancel it in the next step. So this we can write as m into cot phi equal to, so taking m outside here, the numerator I can rearrange the terms and write it can as, it can be written as cos m theta plus sin m theta divided by, okay, it is not plus, cos m theta minus sin m theta divided by cos m theta plus sin m theta. Okay, this is m into. So you can cancel m on both sides. So canceling m on both sides and dividing both numerator and denominator on right hand term by cos m theta, this will be cot phi equal to cos m theta times 1 minus sin m theta by cos m theta, that is tan m theta, divided by, again here taking cos m theta outside, 1 plus tan m theta. So cos m theta cancels. Now cot phi equal to, okay, cot phi equal to, I said already, I think I have mentioned in one of the previous class, 1 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan theta is cot of pi by 4 plus theta. This I have already mentioned again. So using that result, this will be cot of pi by 4 plus m theta we have. So therefore phi equal to pi by 4 plus m theta. Phi equal to pi by 4 plus m theta. Anyway, I got phi explicitly. So now consider, p equal to r sin phi. Consider p equal to r sin phi. That implies p equal to r into sin of phi means pi by 4 plus m theta. Pi by 4 plus m theta. So that implies p equal to r into, see we have sin of a plus b equal to sin a cos b, sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Using that result, we'll be getting r times of sin a, that is sin of pi by 4 into cos m theta plus cos pi by 4 plus into sin m theta. But sin pi by 4 and cos pi by 4 both equal to 1 by root 2. Sin pi by 4, cos pi by 4 both equal to 1 by root 2. So you can take that 1 by root outside. R by root 2 times, here if I remove 1 by root 2, I will be getting cos m theta. Plus, here taking 1 by root outside, I will be remaining with sin m theta. Sin m theta. So I got p equal to, you can call this as equation 1, p equal to r by root 2 into cos m theta plus sin m theta. So here the given equation, given r power m equal to a power m cos m theta plus sin m theta. So that implies from this I will be having cos m theta plus sin m theta equal to r power m divided by a power m. Substituting this in equation 1. Substituting it in equation 1, we'll be getting p equal to r divided by square root of 2 into, so in place of cos m theta plus sin m theta, I should write r power m divided by a power m. R power m divided by a power m. So that implies p equal to r power m plus 1 divided by square root of 2 into a power m. R equivalent, you can write r power m plus 1 equal to square root of 2 into a power m p. That is the required PR equation. Okay, this problem E. Problem F. L by R. This we have already considered once again. L by R equal to 1 plus E cos theta. Solution. As usual, given L by R equal to 1 plus E cos theta. Okay, taking log on both sides, we'll be getting log L minus log R equal to log of 1 plus E cos theta. Now, differentiating with respect to theta, we'll be getting 0 minus 1 by R into dr by d theta equal to 1 plus E cos theta. In the numerator, it will be minus E sin theta. So we can cancel negative sign on both sides. So we'll be getting cot phi equal to E sin theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta. See, from this we'll be getting phi equal to cot inverse of something, but substituting that in P equal to R sin phi, you don't get anything. That will be highly difficult. So you cannot get phi explicitly here. You have to continue with only cot phi. So consider. So here I can't use P equal to R sin phi, but I can use 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times 1 plus cot square phi. So now it will be 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times 1 plus cot phi means E sin theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta. Substituting that here, E sin theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta whole square. Now expanding this, it will be, I'll write from here, 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times 1 plus E square sin square theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta whole square. Can we expand this? Okay, time being, let us write this as 1 plus E cos theta whole square. Now it will be 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times, cross multiplying this, it will be 1 plus E cos theta whole square plus E square sin square theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta whole square. Now, so this implies 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times, expand the numerator term, a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Next, it will be plus e square sin square theta divided by 1 plus E cos theta whole square. Okay, this becomes what? 1 plus 2 times of E cos theta plus E square. Okay, instead of this, we can do like this only. Okay, this we can remove. It will be a bit difficult. Okay, better recall this as equation 1. I think we already used equation 1. Yes, we have already used equation 1. Now call this as equation 2. Calling this as equation 2. Now, so from the given, so anyway we have here P, R and theta. Now consider the given equation. The given equation is L by R equal to 1 plus E cos theta. Now try to eliminate theta between these two. That is the better way. So ಮುಂಚೆ ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಹಂಗೆ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ತುಂಬ ಲೆಂತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಥರನೇ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಇಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇ ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಯರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡು ದಿಸ್? ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 1 ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಇ ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ. So if you square both sides, it will be squaring, it will be L by R minus 1 whole square equal to E cos theta whole square. L by R minus 1 whole square equal to E cos theta whole square. See, I want expression for E sine E square sine square theta. Yes, I want expression for E square sine square theta. But here I have in terms of cos theta. So this we can write as, if you take E square outside, 1 minus cos square theta, right? Sine square theta can be written in this form. So it will be E square minus E square cos square theta. So E square minus E square cos square theta will be sin square theta. So this will be L by R minus 1 whole square equal to E square cos square theta. So from this you can write E square cos square theta equal to E square cos square theta equal to, taking this term to the left hand side, it will be E square minus E square sin square theta. Or okay, but idella simplification tale ketskolakke hogbidi. It will be L by R minus 1 whole square equal to E square times 1 minus sin square theta. So which is E square minus E square sin square theta. So that's what I write there. So from this E square sin square theta, E square sin square theta, taking that to the left hand side, that will be E square minus L by R minus 1 whole square. E square sin square theta is E square minus L by R minus 1 whole square. Now I got L by R minus 1 equal to E cos theta, and E square minus L by R minus 1 whole square equal to E square sin square theta. Substituting that in equation 2, we will be getting left hand side 1 by P square equal to 1 by R square times 1 plus, so E square sin square theta plus only E square minus L by R minus 1 whole square divided by the denominator 1 plus E cos theta is L by R whole square. Now simplify this, you get PR equation. Now okay, this will be, I'll write from here, 1 by P square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus, see this l by r minus 1, you can write that as l minus r divided by r, right? So e square minus of l by r by r, sorry, l minus r divided by r whole square divided by l square by r square. It involves so many steps, but I have to do it carefully. So 1 plus, this is nothing but l minus r whole square divided by r square. So e square minus l minus r whole square divided by r square, whole divided by l square divided by, can I bring this r square to the numerator? It will be what? L square in the denominator. So whole thing into, whole thing into r square. Now this becomes 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus, multiplying that r square inside, multiplying that r square inside, you will be getting, will be getting r square e square minus l minus r whole square all divided by l square. Now expand this l minus r whole square. So 1 by p square equal to 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square, it will be as it is your outside of the bracket. So 1 by r square times l square, cross multiplying this, l square plus r square e square minus, expanding this, a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, that is l square minus 2lr plus r square all divided by l square. So 1 by p square equal to 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times l square plus r square a square minus l square plus 2lr minus r square divided by l square. So l square get cancelled here. You have r square a square plus 2lr minus r square. So 1 by p square times, I can take this r square inside, right? So in the numerator, r square e square plus 2lr minus r square. So okay, that is taking inside, you will be getting r square e square minus 2lr minus r square divided by r square l square. So this you can write as r square times e square minus 1 divided by r square l square minus 2lr divided by r square l square. Okay, just I have grouped these two. So taking r square outside, you will get e square minus 1 divided by r square l square minus 2lr divided by r square l square. So 1 by p square equal to r square you can cancel here, e square minus 1 divided by l square plus, it is minus, minus 2 by lr. This is the required, that is the required PR equation. So that is the required PR equation. So sorry, it is a plus 12, forget this, plus 2 lr by r square. So it is plus 2lr from here. So finally, there is one more. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. That is r power n equal to a power n secant h n theta. So this is the last problem. R power n equal to a power n secant h n theta. As usual, taking log on both sides. Okay. Sorry, I have to write solution. So given r power n equal to a power n secant h n theta. Hyperbolic function this is. So taking log on both sides. Taking log on both sides, it will be n log r equal to log a power n plus log secant h n theta. So now differentiating with respect to theta, it will be n by r into dr by d theta equal to 0 plus minus n secant h n theta into tan h n theta. Derivative secant h n theta is minus secant h n theta into tan h n theta secant h n theta. Either you can say hyperbolic secant theta or secant h n theta. Hyperbolic secant n theta ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು ಅಥವಾ secant h n theta ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು. This is the hyperbolic function. So cancelling n on both sides, we will be getting cot phi equal to again secant h n theta, secant h n theta get cancelled, minus tan h n theta. Here also you cannot use that result here, minus tan theta equal to cot of pi by 2 plus theta. That is valid for only trigonometric function. This is hyperbolic function, but again it comes under trigonometric function, but the properties of hyperbolic functions varies from the properties of trigonometric functions. So we have this one, cot phi equal to tan minus tan h n theta. You can stop here only. Then consider here, I can't consider p equal to r sin phi, but I can consider 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus cot square phi. If you consider this, 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square, we have cot phi, so that will be 1 plus tan h n theta. You can neglect negative sign, because anyway squaring the term will get positive. So it will be 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus tan h square n theta. But tan h square n theta is, we have this result, 1 minus tan h square n theta equal to secant h square n theta. Okay, so from this we have to obtain expression for this. Okay, let us keep this as it is. From this we can write secant h square n theta equal to 1 minus tan h square n theta. See how it will be useful. Okay, let us stop this, call this as equation 2. Now the given thing, what is the given? R power n equal to a power n secant h n theta. R power n equal to secant h n theta, and we have this result, 1 minus tan h square n theta equal to secant h square n theta, right? So from this we have r power n equal to, sorry, r power n divided by a power n equal to secant h square n theta. But we have 1 minus tan h square n theta, right? So 1 minus tan h square n theta, you can substitute here. Okay, let's stop here. So from this equation, we have tan h square n theta equal to 1 minus secant h square n theta. Okay, that will be useful, I think. We have tan h square n theta equal to 1 minus secant h square n theta, that will be 1 minus r power n divided by a power n whole square. Okay, I can prove like this. 1 minus r power n divided by a power n whole square. Substituting these in equation 2, you'll be getting 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 1 plus substituting for tan h square theta, I'll be getting 1 minus r power, see r power n whole square, that is r power 2n divided by a power 2n. So 1 plus 1, you get 2. Therefore, 1 by p square equal to 1 by r square times 2 minus r power 2n divided by a power 2n. This is the required PR equation. You can stop here. If you want, you can simplify this. This will be 2 by r square minus r power 2n minus 2 divided by a power n. Nothing else is required. You can stop here only. So with this, we have discussed some problems on PR equations. So there are some exercise problems that I will be given later. And in the next class, we are going to discuss curvature and radius of curvature. So I'm not going to continue on PR equations again. So let us discuss a new concept in the next class.